fina, asa benga muti, bentara fofe, asa benga muti, bama yuche mi amerai, asa benga muti, tama wala marwe, asa benga muti, tan sobe mu, asa benga muti, ye DJ vibes again.
Please put your hands together. First of all, I want to take this opportunity to thank all of everybody here for coming. I also want to thank you guys for acknowledging us.
Amen.
We're taking, I'm going to speak on behalf of myself and the fellow nominee, I mean honorees. I am speechless. I am honored and I feel very acknowledged. And I'm pretty much sure that every one of us that have received this felt the same way. I am impressed in the sense that I said in the table where I'm sitting, I said this is our own Anderson Cooper honoring his heroes. I must say because normally people don't take notice of what others are doing.
Yeah.
And some of us do things because it's our calling to do what we need to do to make a living.
Yes.
But for you guys to sit in your corner and take notice of each and every person here tonight, the accomplishment, what they've done, without us even knowing that you guys are taking our talk, we must say we appreciate you guys for doing it. And I feel very motivated, very challenged tonight. I go back with a different feeling when I leave here. So thank you guys for everything. Now to introduce my, what would I say, my big sis. When I went to Harvard at age 12, she was very, very much my senior. But guess what? She taught me to do stuff that I never knew how to do. She took care of me in school. So up to this day, I call her big sis. She wrote something out here for me to read, but I'm going to say it.
Go ahead.
Auntie Matilda has been a senior prefect in school since I went to Harvard way back in, I've known her since 1975. I'm just 25 years old. She has been my senior in school. I respect her, not because she's sitting here. I admire her. She's very down to earth. She went to Harvard. From there, she went to college. And then she came here, she continued. I'm just following your footsteps.
Oh.
But guess what? Like she rightly put it, she's a journalist. But then she decided not to go on that path. She decided to take the calling that our God called her to do. She is not only my pastor, she's a prayer warrior. And she's been almost everywhere, you name it. Internationally, she travels just to preach the word of God. It's quite a sacrifice for us, for me to say this, in the sense that for you to leave what you've gone to school for and decided to take that calling, not all of us, I could say, I'm not sure, I'm going to follow your footsteps, maybe down the road to go to Bible school, but to decide to go on that path and devote yourself on it 100%, solid on it, and you're doing it to perfection, I must say, I admire you and I respect you for that. And she's been giving a lot to us. She call her any time of the day and say, Auntie Matty, can you pray with me? She's ready to. Let me see what she says here. Dr. Matilda Banga has a background in journalism and has served her country as a personal assistant to the then president of her country, Sierra Leone. During the Rebel War, she served her nation by leading delegations to the Republic of Guinea and worked with the team of the United Nations Humanitarian Commission for Refugee to bring Sierra Leone to the peace which she enjoys today. Dr. Matilda has touched lives of so many young people and raised leaders. Like I said, I didn't even know what you wrote, but that's who she is. And I respect you. All I could ask for is for God to continue to give you the sense of direction, to lead you, expand your territory, Amen. And take you to the next level. Amen. And be sure. Please join me in welcoming.
DJ this. Until I have music.
That's right.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Oh. All right, when they're ready, I'm going to say no. Oh boy. I don't know this one, but it's okay. I don't know this one, though.
I don't like it.
And I know we going to
I'm honored to introduce this special person. I have not known her so long, but I think I am so astonished and surprised at who she is. Whenever I see her, she's always wearing a different clothes, and but she wears different hats. And every time she can switch her mouth, and she can switch her brain, and she can switch her heart, but her heart is always same. There's no war in her. She's amazingly capable. So I wanna, now I'm gonna read this written statement about her. Dr. Patricia Kidwell is being recognized and awarded as a first-class educator, as a president of My Life Bible College, graduating over 150 students in the last 2 years. She's also being awarded for her impeccable sense of style, as always staying on top of fashion and design with high standard. She's a wonderful leader in our community. Let us welcome Dr. Patra Kidwell. Thank you.
Well, the ladies are in the house today. We want to take the picture so that I clap your hands. I want to have some fun. Yes, come have fun now.
Thank you very much. We're going to talk about engineers. And in the field of engineering, there are different subcategories
about engineering. But one thing I realized is that there are some areas of engineering that people don't usually look at. Sometimes when you say electrical engineering, they think it's just to put a bulb or a light bulb or two. But it goes way beyond that. And sometimes when you say mechanical engineering, you think it's just about putting up a bolt or two. We forget the time, the love, and the patience and the care. We are giving this award to this gentleman because I think of times like this when it's cold and it's winter and it's raining and there's snow. But a mechanical engineer will go under the snow and the winter and the rain to make sure you get your cars to go to work. Put your hands together. A mechanical auto repair engineer will ensure that no matter what happens, your car is in a good shape so that you do not get into any form of accident. We chose this because we know that it's an important area.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, this individual is a very humble and passionate individual who changed his career from being a flight engineer to a mechanical engineer. And he did this in a bid to serve his family and community. For over 20 years, this fine gentleman has provided auto repair and mechanical service with excellence, I must add. And his legacy remains in the fact that there are customers he has had for as long as 20 years. For somebody to have a list of customers, we welcome to the podium.
He has a big auto shop.
He has a big auto shop. I hope you brought your cars.
Yeah.
If you want the best mechanic that will not cheat on you, that will do it on time,
right.
This is the individual. And I'm going to call her daughter, Nadia. Oh. Please come up and come with your daddy.
So I was trying to sneak behind him. He didn't even know I was here.
Oh, you're going to sneak behind. Please help me welcome Alhaji Mohamed Salman Azim. Put your hands together. Let's hear the music.
I'm 2014 was a fantastic year for Front Page Film Studio. 2015 is already here. At Front Page Film Studio, image is everything.
When you see a woman,
give us a call. We'll help you capture those lovely moments.
It's that time of the year again. Here at Front Page Film Studios, we specialize in wedding videos, video editing, and documentary and short films, just to name a few. So please, don't hesitate to give us a phone call at 301-613-7044. Make sure to ask for Yusuf Dean Cisse, our CEO. Here at Front Page Film Studios, image is everything. So please.